WLAN planning in warehouse scenarios. Welcome to the WLAN network planning class. In this course, we will show you how to plan a WLAN in a warehouse scenario. Upon completion of this course, you will be able to know the areas in a warehouse, corresponding WLAN planning solutions, and reasons for choosing different solutions in these areas. First, let's take a look at Wi-Fi coverage requirements in a typical warehouse scenario. A typical scenario in a warehouse is goods picked by scanning barcodes. According to the orders and instructions distributed by the system, a picker drags a cart around the warehouse and picks goods by scanning barcodes at the goods storage area. After picking goods, the picker delivers the goods to the packing area for packing and then completes the outbound in the receiving area. Let's dive into this typical scenario. The STA is a PDA scanner that needs bandwidth of only several kilobits per second for each scanning. The STA roams frequently among scenarios, including the high shelf area, low shelf area, receiving area, packing area, and office area. In the high shelf area, forklift trucks are used to pick up goods. In the low shelf area and other areas, pickers can pick up goods. Let's see the key points of this requirement. First, analyze the specific scenarios in the warehouse, including the high shelf area, low shelf area, receiving area, packing area, and office area. Then, determine the service requirement, that is, picking goods by scanning barcodes. PDA scanners are used, which require low bandwidth and frequently roam. Next, let's look at the structure of a typical logistics warehouse. The office area is on the left, and the large area in the middle is the high shelf area. The high shelf area is divided into four warehouses through concrete. Next to it, we see the low shelf area, packing area, and picking area. The height of a typical warehouse is 10 meters. The height of shelves in the high shelf area ranges from 8 meters to 10 meters, and that of shelves in the low shelf area ranges from 1.5 meters to 2.4 meters. The height of the dock in the packing area ranges from 1.2 meters to 1.5 meters. This is the actual photo. You can easily see that shelves in the high shelf area are almost as high as the warehouse height, while those in the low shelf area are relatively low and may be only 2 to 3 meters high. The goods in the receiving area are stacked in bulk and are usually no more than 2 meters high. Office seats are scattered in the office area. Let's experience our delivery solution through this project. The first is the high shelf area. In the vertical direction, for each row of shelves, install APs at a spacing of 45 meters. In the horizontal direction, install an AP for every two shelves. APs in two adjacent rows are placed in staggered mode, forming a W-shaped layout, which is similar to the indoor layout. Next, we come to the low shelf area and packing area. In these areas, APs are installed at a spacing of about 30 meters. When multiple rows of APs are required, APs are deployed in equilateral triangles to form an N shape. That is, when there are a large number of APs in the packing area, deploy the APs in W mode. The final AP locations are subject to the network planning result, ensuring that the Wi-Fi signal strength in the warehouse is greater than -65 dBm. The signal strength of no less than -65 dBm is a basic requirement for a good network, and this is what we have been emphasizing. Then, let's analyze the AP deployment solutions in different areas. What are their differences? We can see that APs in the low shelf area are deployed at a spacing of 30 meters in triangles, forming a W-shaped layout. Do you find this deployment familiar? This is actually the same as the deployment mode in the open indoor installation scenario. The only difference is that in this area, the AP spacing is larger, around 30 meters. Why? This is because the requirements for bandwidth and field strength in warehouse scenarios are slightly lower than those in common indoor scenarios. Then let's look at the high shelf area. APs for the same shelf row are deployed at a spacing of 45 meters. Horizontally, APs are deployed for every two shelves. That is, the deployment mode in the vertical direction considers this scenario an open environment, similar to that in the low shelf area and packing area. In contrast, The deployment mode in the horizontal direction considers shelves obstacles, similar to walls. Let's go back to the previous photos. In most cases, the warehouse height may be about 10 meters. In areas such as the low shelf area, receiving area, and office areas, the goods are placed in low positions. There is a relative height from the shelf to the ceiling. Therefore, in such scenarios, signals from APs installed on the ceiling can penetrate the shelves for coverage. The shelf height will not affect or block our signals. Such scenarios are considered an open scenario, and APs are deployed at a spacing of 30 meters in equilateral triangles. However, shelves in the high shelf area are high and are quite close to the ceiling. APs cannot directly cover the target area because the shelves will block signals. Therefore, when planning a WLAN for the high shelf area, we use a shelf as the basic unit. The AP spacing is 45 meters at the most. Since we consider the shelves as walls, we can think about how the APs can cover multiple rows of shelves through the walls. This depends on the specific materials of the shelves and goods and the density of the goods. This is not like indoor deployment, where we know regular wall thickness, regular models, and attenuation caused by different materials. These specifications differ in different warehouses, so we need to test attenuation based on the actual situation to see whether signals can pass through the shelves for coverage. In a word, the maximum AP spacing in the high shelf area is 45 meters, and a row of shelves is considered a wall. Then we can determine whether signals can pass through the walls based on the actual test result. Then we need to check whether to install APs for each row or for every other row. This is the high shelf area. Then the deployment in the low shelf area is simple. We can deploy APs at a spacing of 30 meters in equilateral triangles. That is, consider this area an open area. Note that goods and their materials greatly differ depending on the specific warehouse. It is difficult to directly recommend the deployment mode based on the Wi-Fi signal penetration capability. Therefore, the essential factor is to ensure that the Wi-Fi signal strength in the warehouse is no less than minus 65 dBm. Next, let's see the recommended AP and antenna installation. In this example, AP4151 and AP6150 are used. Why are these two types of APs selected? Because they have external omnidirectional antennas. Take an AP4151 as an example. It supports two antennas whose directions can be split as required. Especially in such a high shelf area, for example, if the AP is installed above the shelves to enable Wi-Fi signals to cover the local or adjacent shelves, you must ensure good coverage for both these directions. In this case, adjust the two antennas to the two directions. Place the antenna connected to antenna port A parallel to the ground, with its main lobe covering the front and rear directions of the aisle. Place the antenna connected to antenna port B vertical to the ground, with its main lobe covering the surrounding aisles horizontally in omnidirectional mode. Finally, let's summarize the general rules for network planning. First of all, based on the AP installation height, two scenarios are involved, 10 meters and 15 meters. The higher the installation height is, the more likely coverage holes will occur. Even in the high shelf area, barcodes are scanned only in the bottom row, which is around 2 meters high. Therefore, a higher installation position indicates the poorer signal strength, and APs are deployed closer to each other. At a height of 10 meters in the high shelf area, install APs at a spacing of 45 meters for the same row of shelves. For the adjacent row of shelves, install an AP for every two other rows so that the APs in the two rows are in a W-shaped, staggered manner. When the height is 15 meters, the AP spacing in the same row of shelves becomes 35 meters, and the APs for the adjacent row of shelves are still deployed in W-shaped mode. In the low shelf area, at a height of 10 meters, install APs deployed at a spacing of 30 meters. If the area is large, deploy APs in equilateral triangles to form an N-shaped layout. When the distance is 15 meters, the spacing is 25 meters. The overall guideline is that the minimum field strength in the warehouse is greater than minus 65 dBm. That's all for today. Thank you.